Hello viewers, I welcome you all to the talk on Schrodinger time independent wave equation. The objective of today's talk is to derive Schrodinger time independent wave equation for matter waves of a moving particle. After learning this topic, learners will be able to understand and explain the need of Schrodinger wave equation. They discuss how the expression for de Broglie wavelength is connected with the classical wave equation for a moving particle. They will be able to derive Schrodinger time independent wave equation. Before starting the class, let us understand what is Schrodinger wave equation. It is the basic equation of motion of matter waves. Schrodinger wave equation describes the wave nature of a particle in a mathematical form. It is a partial differential equation that describes the dynamics of quantum mechanical systems using a wave function psi of x, y, z and t. Schrodinger wave equation is a new type of equation that connects de Broglie matter waves with a classical wave equation for a moving particle. Its solution gives the trajectory, the position, momentum and energy of the particle. There are two types of Schrodinger wave equation. One is time independent and the other is time dependent Schrodinger wave equation. In today's class, let us learn how to derive the time independent Schrodinger wave equation. In the entire universe, the existing things are appearing in two entities. One is particle and the other is waves. Particles are localized bundles of energy and momentum with mass m. Waves are the disturbances that are spreading in space and traveling over time. Matter waves can be described with the help of a wave function psi, which is depending on the space and time coordinates t. Let us consider a particle of mass m moving with velocity v. According to de Broglie theory, the particle, when it is moving, it will be associated with matter waves whose wavelength is given by lambda equal to h by mv. Here you can see a particle of mass m moving with velocity v along the x-axis. When the particle is moving, it is always associated with a group of waves called matter waves. Where the amplitude of the wave is higher, you can probably find the particle there. Let x, y, z be the coordinates of the particle and the wave function psi be the amplitude or wave displacement of this de Broglie matter wave. So psi represents the amplitude or the wave displacement of the matter wave. Psi should be finite, single value, continuous and a periodic function. The classical differential equation of wave motion is given by dou squared psi by dou t squared, which is equal to v squared of dou squared psi by dou x squared plus dou squared psi by dou y squared plus dou squared psi by dou z squared. This can be written as v squared del squared psi, where del squared is dou squared by dou x squared plus dou squared by dou y squared plus dou squared by dou z squared and is called Laplacian operator. And v is the velocity of the particle. Psi equal to sine of sine omega t, which can be written as psi naught sine 2 pi nu t. So from this we understand that the angular frequency omega is 2 pi nu and psi naught is a constant. Nu is the frequency of the stationary wave associated with the particle. Now let us differentiate equation 2 twice and we will be getting dou psi by dou t equal to psi naught is a constant. You have to write like this. then you differentiate sine 2 pi nu t with respect to time t. So you get dou psi by dou t equal to sine of 2 pi nu cos 2 pi nu t. Once again, when you differentiate, you'll be getting minus psi naught of 2 pi nu the square sine 2 pi nu t. Minus sine is coming because when we differentiate cos, it becomes sine with a minus sine. So dou squared psi by dou t squared is equal to minus psi naught of 2 pi nu square sine 2 pi nu t. Now we know for light wave, velocity c equal to nu lambda. Now here we are considering a particle wave. The particle is moving with velocity v, so we can write v equal to nu lambda. So from this expression, you can find out what is nu. Nu equal to v by lambda. So you can substitute in this expression and get the equation. So dou squared psi by dou t squared is equal to, you expand this, you'll be getting minus 4 pi squared nu squared sine naught sine 2 pi nu t. So you can write the sine naught sine 2 pi nu t as the solution psi. So the expression becomes dou squared psi by dou t squared is equal to minus 4 pi squared nu squared psi, which is equal to minus 4 pi squared. For nu, you substitute from this expression v by lambda. So nu squared becomes v squared by lambda squared psi. Now substituting this value of dou squared psi by dou t squared from equation 3 in equation 1, we get minus 4 pi squared v squared by lambda squared psi equal to v squared del squared psi. This is a wave equation. Initially, we assumed from classical mechanics, that is, wave equation is dou squared psi by dou t squared is equal to v squared del squared psi. Now, we have substituted the value for dou squared psi by dou t squared as minus 4 pi squared v squared by lambda squared psi in that expression. So we are getting this expression. Now we rearrange the previous equation. Once again, have a look at. So you bring this term v squared cancels. You bring this term to the left hand side and rewrite the equation. We will be getting del squared psi plus 4 pi squared by lambda squared psi equal to 0. From de Broglie relation, we know lambda equal to h by mv. Substitute this value here, your equation becomes del squared psi plus 4 pi squared. For lambda, you substitute, you are getting h squared, m squared, v squared psi equal to 0. So we are getting del squared psi plus 4 pi squared by h squared, m squared, v squared psi equal to 0. Now, if we consider E and V to be the total and potential energies of the particle respectively, then its kinetic energy can be given as E is the total energy, V is the potential energy. So we know the kinetic energy half mv squared becomes E minus V. Now this you multiply and divide by m, you'll be getting the expression m squared v squared by 2m equal to E minus V. From this you find out what is m squared v squared. So m squared v squared becomes 2m of E minus V. Now substitute this expression, this value of m squared v squared in equation 5. Equation 5 becomes del squared psi plus 4 pi squared by h squared into 2m of E minus V psi equal to 0. Now rearrange. So this expression, once again, you look at. You multiply del squared psi plus 2 into 4 pi squared by h squared becomes 8 pi squared by h squared m into E minus V into psi equal to 0. So you will be getting del squared psi plus 8 pi squared m by h squared of E minus V psi equal to 0. This equation is known as Schrodinger time independent wave equation. You cannot find time anywhere here. So it is called Schrodinger time independent wave equation. Now you substitute h cross as h by 2 pi in this equation. So your expression becomes del squared psi plus 2m by h cross squared of e minus v psi equal to 0. For a free particle, v becomes 0. So when the particle is moving, the potential energy becoming 0. So equation 8 can be written for a free particle as del squared psi plus 2m by h cross squared e psi equal to 0. Now throughout this equation, you multiply by h cross squared by 2m. Your expression becomes h cross squared by 2m del squared psi plus e minus v psi equal to 0. Now you keep v this side and take e to the right hand side, you will be getting h cross squared by 2m del squared psi minus v psi equal to e psi. Now take psi outside the bracket, you can write minus h cross squared by 2m del squared plus v of psi equal to e psi. So for this, you can write h operator psi, which is equal to e psi, where h operator equal to minus h cross squared by 2m del squared plus v, and is known as Hamiltonian operator. I hope you have understood how to derive Schrodinger time independent wave equation. So here we have h operator psi equal to e psi. There is no time factor here. That is why we call this as time independent wave equation. I hope you have understood how to derive Schrodinger time independent wave equation. Thank you all.